Good to be back. Today, you'll notice that we have a piece of equipment in our hands. It's a bit strange, isn't it? Now, many of you might say, well, I don't have a stick like this at home. But I'll bet you all, when you go home, you'll find a stick of some sort or other, whether it's the brush handle, or the old twig, or the golf club, be careful. Or what else could we use? The walking stick, right, okay. We were hoping you wouldn't need the walking sticks.
And out, and in, and down. Okay, the next one, we want to do it to the chest. Don't lock out your elbows, if you know what I mean. No need for that. Lovely. Nice twisty movement. You can't hurt yourself too much because you're sitting. But we're doing the standing up, you can easily twist. Lift your hand, your leg, sorry. Change your hand, right? And then opposite hand, opposite leg, opposite hand, opposite leg. You could do it like that, or you could be very smart and try doing it like that. It's up to yourselves. Practice it for St. Patrick's Day Parade. Lovely. Very important to move your trunk. Your trunk starts at your head, that goes down your back, right? But it is actually very important to move that trunk. And down. So just drop it onto your chair there. Feel it there, on the chair. Then put your hand behind it. Okay, okay, okay. Nobody's perfect. Excellent. All right. Now, as if you were drying your back with a towel. It's actually easier than it looks. Yes?
No. First try one to let it fall has to tidy up.
Try doing it with your mouth closed. Everybody opens their mouth. Right. In this section, we're going to use a little bit of equipment to add a little weight to your exercise routine. You can use a stick if you have it. You can use a broom handle. You can use any kind of your own walking stick or a towel, any piece of equipment that you can find in the house. It doesn't have to be a coloured stick. Okay, so put it on your knees and just roll it there to get yourself and your hands into getting ready to use your stick. Okay, just lift it slightly, and for your wrists, just twist, 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 twist. One way, then the other way, and backwards, 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 and backwards. Then put your hands underneath, and you're bringing your stick to your chest, and down, nice and easy. And again, and down, and last time, and down, and take it down. Put your hands over to get a different position. Lift it to your chest and push it out and in and out and in and out and in. And it's like a rowing movement. You can put your back into it if you feel confident to put in and rowing and rowing. Okay, and down. And this time, I want you to lift it to your chest and lift it up to your chest and down. Chest high, up, chest and down. Chest high, up, chest and down. Last time, up, chest and down. Excellent. Now, put your stick like this, and instead of rowing, we want you to go punting down the river. Again, using your back. Lovely. That's it. Nice big hand movement. Last time to one side, and last time, and back. And very nice. Excellent. Now, we're going to just place our hands around, just taking it up. Be careful there's nobody in front of you when you're doing this. That's lovely. And last time, bringing that down. Now to introduce the legs, you can start nice and gently tapping and tapping and tapping and tapping, and you can move it up and up and up and down, and then you can progress to lifting your knee, getting this in one hand and down, then to the other one, up and down, then do it again. Just a little bit of coordination and get a little faster, reminiscent of the twig dance of old. Lovely. And again, if you can't manage that, just tap and tap and down. Okay. Put it in the center to involve the back again. Imagine we're stirring the pot, a grand big pot, right around and right around, and then back to the other way, whoop, and back the other way. And last time, and on. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to take it down and twisting movement around. So we just take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and right around using the stick for stability. And 2, 3, 4. Do it one more time. Around to one side, bringing your head round and round to the other side, bringing your head around. Alternatively, you can do it with your stick. Try keeping your arms as far and as wide as you can to open up your chest. Out and going around to one side again. Back to center. Round to the side. Back to center. Bring it down. And let's do that one more time. Round. Center. Round. Center and down. Very good. For your fingers, nice little exercise for your fingers would be to just twirl this as if you were twirling and practicing for St. Patrick's Day in your baton. And if you're very good, you can do your left hand. It's a good practice for your fingers right around. So just twirl it around. It's very important to keep this movement so that you're able to scratch your own back, button your own blouses or shirts. So this is a really good one for it. Put it in your hand, put it down your back, get it down onto the chair. It's nice and handy. It's not complicated. Take it in your hand and just gently ease up as if you were drying your back with a towel. And then just increase your movement. And down, increase, and down. Last time, and down. Okay, take it around, and the other way. Just bring it back, take your hand, up nice and straight. It can be here, it doesn't matter. It's entirely to your own capability to put it up and down, up and down, up and down, up. And down, and last time, up and down, bring it down and round. Well done.